Well, we found out that firms in the wealth management space aren't really coping the right way, let's say, with client lifecycle. I was recently in a meeting with a lady that's our project sponsor at a client, a very large client. And this lady, Lisa, was telling me, actually, you know, after launching the onboarding initiative with you, we really got faster in onboarding clients and meeting their expectation with this initial first impression that counts a lot. But now there's something else that keeps me up tonight. And I was like, yes, please, Lisa, tell me, go forward. And she told me, well, actually, you know, 70% of the activity that we in the company carry on over a year are actually tied to updating and maintaining the client's information and relationship in terms of the services, the accounts, the portfolio, investments. And so it's really a high operational burden for us. So it's really onboarding as opposed to client lifecycle is really just at the tip point of the iceberg. And there's this massive workload that you have to tackle for the ongoing relationship. What we are observing in the market is that one of the biggest barriers in wealth management for client lifecycle management is really the inefficient workload distribution across the different swim lanes, as we call them, so the different groups and participants and stakeholders that have to approve or validate a change or even just information updating in the client's situation and dossier. And when I say inefficient workload distribution, I really point out to the fact that there is a big gap in terms of tools, and I mean technology, that enable parallel work patterns, a more flexible, if you will, way of working and collaborating with the different stakeholders across the company in the different departments. The first one would be definitely boosting your advisors and relationship managers with what is defined as empathic banking. And what is it? It's basically the ability to understand and feel the changes that your customer is going through, and being able to suggest moving forward what are the next steps, what are the opportunities for your customer. So the second element would be enabling the collaboration, a right collaboration across the different departments and stakeholders in the firm. Because in the end, in wealth management, the final customer is not a simple customer usually. So they have cross-regional and cross-jurisdiction interests, and you need as a wealth manager to support this complex overview of needs that your customer might have. So collaborating with the right expert in the company to solve that specific side of the challenge is crucial. And then the third element would be enabling the right decision-making, the smart decision-making. And this is possible, again, by pointing back to the right technology that will allow transparency and most of all also traceability. This means a technology tool that helps envisioning what are the different steps needed in the approval of that specific new data or change that you want to incorporate in your client dossier. Being able also to decouple or merge the different paths together so that you are faster and straight to the point.